communication. So, as soon as you heard the word thread, so what is the first picture comes in your mind when you see this word thread? Okay, can anyone unmute yourself and explain what first picture comes in your mind? What is a thread? Simple. In your real world, have you used thread somewhere? What are the uses of a thread? Can you write it down where you have used thread? Or you can speak also. You can unmute yourself and can speak what are the uses of thread you have seen in your real life. Forget about virtual world, that is, forget about operating system, forget about computer system, just we talk about the real world. Have you used a thread in your life? Come on, don't be so dumb. Hey, let me pick it out. Who is there? Anjali, are you there? Anjali? Anjali, are you there? Please unmute yourself. Come on, Anjali. Anjali? Oh, Anjali is not able to hear me. Let me have Abhishek. Abhishek Kumar Dubey. Are you there? Abhishek?
Yes. Yes,
Yes.
sir.
Have you seen thread in your lifetime till now? What are the uses of thread you have seen? I have got some answer. Come on, you can speak. I am reading. Threads mainly used in stitching cloths, typing answer sheets, tying answer sheets. Okay, that's cool. Very good answer. Yes, Abhishek. Yes, Abhishek. Tell me some uses
No,
of
sir.
threads. Yes.
Well, what is threads? I don't know.
You have no idea about thread. I don't think that you have no idea about thread. Thread. What we say thread in Hindi? धागा ना? आपके घर पे धागा नहीं
यस
है?
सर,
रील नहीं है वो धागे वाली जो मम्मी
नहीं
यूज करती?
सर, मम्मी सिलाई करती है। बस सर, अभी हमने ज्वाइन किया ना क्लास, तो अचानक हमने आपने नाम लिया था।
ओके लीव इट. ओके नो इशू. सो टेल मी व्हाट आर द यूसेज ऑफ थ्रेड. अभी हियर यू हैव यूज थ्रेड. एज आई हैव गॉट सम आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स लाइक थ्रेड्स मेनली यूज्ड फॉर स्टिचिंग द क्लॉथ एंड टाइंग द आंसर शीट. वेरी गुड आंसर्स बाय सूर्यांश एंड अनन्या. एंड व्हाट एल्स यूसेज यू हैव सीन ऑफ थ्रेड. कम ऑन टेल मी.
अच्छा,
यस
कटिंग
मैडम.
दैट एग्स
यस.
फॉर कटिंग एग्स कटिंग सर।
I am not able to hear your voice clearly. You can type in the chat box, okay, beta? You can mute yourself and can type write in the chat box. Let me have some more student. Avanish, are you there? Avanish. Avanish Kumar Pankaj. Avanish, am I taking your name correctly? Avanish. Avanish Kumar, are you there? Avanish Kumar Pankaj, are you there? Oh, Abhishek has written something for cutting wild egg. Very good. Very practical example you have given. Very nice. Nice. Very good. I need some more usage of thread. Gaurav Tripathi, are you there? Gaurav? Gaurav?
Yes, sir. Yes,
Yes,
sir. Wait, sir.
I was looking for this answer. I use it for flying kites. Thank you, Gaurav, for giving me this what
Yes,
I'm
sir.
looking for. Okay, who was there?
Yes, sir.
Who is unmute right now? I forget your name. Come on, who was?
Sir, Gaurav, sir.
Yes, Gaurav, sorry, beta. Yes, Gaurav. So,
Yes, sir.
apart from flying the kites, what are the other uses of threads? Come on.
What I use is mainly flying kites, sir, and during examination, it is
During
used for
examination,
tying.
yeah.
Yes, sir, it is used in
And
tying
any
for
other thing?
jeeps.
Have you seen usage of thread by your sister or mother by making their bro, right? Eyebrow? Threading something like?
Yes, sir.
No one is
Threading, sir.
giving
Yeah,
that example, right?
known as threading, sir. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, the threading.
Shweta Yadav has written
I
that
don't
setting the
know about
eyebrow. Very good. Okay, cool. You can mute
my
yourself.
bro.
Thank you, Gaurav. Thank you. Thank you, Shweta. I go for setting the eyebrow. Okay, so these are the usage of you have seen the thread. Now, what is my next question? So you have seen a lot of usage of thread, as you can tie the answer sheet, you can stitch the cloth, you can cut the boiled egg, you can even fly the kites, and making wall hangings. Yes, exactly, Pooja. We can do some decoration kind of thing with the help of thread, like you can hang something not very heavy. And Shweta is saying that we can set eyebrow. Yeah, exactly. We can do these kinds of things. Now, my next question is, so with the help of these examples, can you figure it out what may be the characteristics of a thread? Did you get my question? With the help of these examples, can you figure it out what are the characteristics of a thread? Characteristics, do you understand? Means what are the, like you can say, specifications of a thread, means which you can say that this is a thread, right? So what characteristics you can find out with the help of with these examples? Can you tell me some one or two? Everyone got my question, no? Yes or no? I am looking for the characteristics of a thread that you have given the very good examples, like setting eyebrow, making wall hangings, flying kites, wild legs cutting, and stitching the cloth. So what you can figure it out that what may be the characteristics of a thread? Just forget about virtual world. I am just a thing wants to you to think about in real world that you have used your dhaga in your house and what are the uses you have seen. Then you have to just figure it out what may be the characteristics of a thread. Come on, tell me. Pretty simple. This is not a bookish knowledge I am asking you. There is no definition I am asking you about thread. I am just asking you what you have experience in your real life, and if you have experienced those things in your real life, you can easily figure it out what is in virtual world. So I am making you to understand this topic very clearly with the help of your real world experience. Come on, tell me some characteristics. No one is replying. Connecting two things, okay, if you are figure it out, like flexible, sharp, very good, Anand. Very good. Flexible. Thread is very flexible in nature. You can mold it any number of times, and it is very sharp. Like you have needle and you have that thread, and you can very sharply put it into that needle, right? Thin, Rohit, exactly. Very good. I'm getting very good answers. Some more answer can we have? Lightweight. Very good. Lightweight and good strength. And it has that much strength that it can do something, right? Gaurav Singh, sir, for connecting things like it combines all papers. Okay. So I have got a lot of good answers, like Aparna is saying lightweight, good strength, and Rohit is saying flexible, sharp. And can I add one more characteristics in this, that this is something like you can use it in, if you are using it for one particular task, it can work on one task only at a time. Means it can dedicate to, if you are stitching the cloth, you can stitch the cloth at that time only. Means it is very dedicated kind of thing, like sharply can point out on one thing only, right? So these are the characteristics of a thread. Means you have seen that a thread is very flexible, sharp in nature, and it is lightweighted. So we are good with this real world thread. You have got the context, yes or no? That you have got the idea of thread, that these are the usage of real world thread and these are the characteristics of a thread. So context is done. So picture is clear in mind that what we are going to study, we are going to study something which is very lightweighted in nature, very sharp, means looking at the target only, we'll do only one task at a time, and having that much of strength that can perform that one task at a time. Very flexible in nature means it can use its resources very flexibly. Sharp, lightweighted means it will use your system resources very less than your process. Okay, so you have got the context. Now let's see what is a thread and how it is we are using this thread concept of real world in operating system background. Okay, so let's start. So what is a thread? We have seen processes. Processes are what? Heavyweight processes means they can have a lot of resources they can use. Now, what is thread? Thread is a lightweight process. What we can say that thread is a lightweight process means one process can have more than one threads, and these threads can use the same resources of a process. Like you can think of a process as a parent and thread as there as child, but these threads can perform one task only for which they are designed. So it is a basic unit of CPU utilization. It comprises like just like your PCB process control block has some components. Similarly, threads have some components. What it is? A thread ID, a program counter, a register set, and a stack is for memory storage. So what a thread consists of? A thread ID, program counter, register set, and a stack. Now I am giving you some more picture of this thread. What you can imagine in your mind that what may be a thread? If we are saying that thread is a lightweight process, think about something like suppose you are writing your resume in your MS Word, Microsoft Office Word application, you are writing your resume. So have you experienced that if you have sometimes you have written a word at your spelling is there is a typo in the spelling, right? So there is a red underline is there, right? And sometimes there is a green underline whenever you have given more than one space, more than one space, then you have some blue line or green line kind of thing. Like, so you are writing something and it is doing some processing simultaneously with the help of thread. One thread is looking for your spelling check. One thread is looking for that is proper spacing. So these threads are working in parallel continuously while the main process, which is your editing of word, is going on in top level, and these sub levels which can take subtasks can be taken care by the threads only. So we can do many things simultaneously. So what is a thread? Thread is a lightweight process. It is a basic unit of CPU utilization. And what are the components of a thread? A thread ID, a stack, a register set, and a program counter. And it shares with other threads belonging to the same process. What a thread can share with other processes? Its code section, data section, and other operating resources. Other operating resources, what kind of resources? Just like opening a file, so you have to open a file, you have some like pointer for file opening that can be shared by all other threads in that family of process, and other signals that can be taken are the shared by the thread. A traditional or heavyweight process has a single thread of control. If you are talking about a process which is having not having threads, then we can think of that particular process as a single thread of control, means that process is doing only one single task single-handedly. Now, if a process has multiple thread of control, it can perform more than one task at a time. Just like as I have given you an example of writing your resume in your MS Word, we are doing multiple tasks at a time. One thread is looking for your spelling check. One thread is looking for proper spacing, right? And if you have chosen that justify or left align or middle or right align, then one thread is looking for that adjusting also, right? If you are using that numbering or you are using bullets, you have chosen, then one thread is also looking for that adjusting. So we are doing multiple tasks at a time, but as a whole, you are thinking that you are working on MS Word process only at this moment, but there are multiple short jobs are there, and you can see that while you are checking the spelling, you are in that particular process only. You are sharing the resources like code section, data section, and other resources of that file. So this thread, using these threads, is very making the system very flexible in nature, and these threads can do their job very sharply. So as you can now, you can relate with your real world characteristics of a thread, why we are calling these as threads. Now let's see single threaded process versus multi-threaded process. Now we have given you one example that one process, if it is having only single thread control, then it can do only one task at a time. And if we are having multi-thread control, then we can perform multiple tasks at a time. Let's see in a diagram we are having in left hand side single thread process, and in the right side we are having multi-threaded process. Now what we can see here that in single thread process, apart from this code, data and file section, registers and stack, we are having only single thread control, and this is doing only one task at a time. Now what is multi-threaded process block is here? You can see code, data and files are common in place, that is they can be shared by all these threads. Now these threads have separate registers and stack, as you have seen that what are the components of a thread. For these registers and stack are the for tracking this activity of this particular task which is taken by this thread only. So in this manner these three threads can perform simultaneously multiple tasks at a time. So this is called multi-thread process control. Now let's see what is a multi-threaded server architecture. As you have seen, suppose you have to download the admit card from the Lucknow University website, then how maybe that server is working to make you convenient to download the admit card, right? Suppose you have sent the request to these are my credentials and you want to download the admit card, right? You have sent the request. Now that server given firstly check your credentials that you are the authentic persons to you can download the admit card. Now it create a thread that can let you download the PDF file of your admit card, and then it started to listen other users request to download the admit card. In this manner it can be scalable in nature, means it can cater a lot of number of users at a time by making a separate thread for downloading the admit card. Okay, so let's see how it works. In multi-threaded server architecture, the server will create a separate thread that listens for client request. As I've told you that in multi-threaded server architecture, what will happen? That multiple clients are there and server is only one. Now one server has to take care of, suppose I can say that there are 1000 of user, for example, then one server can one time can take care of only one user, but if it can create multiple threads to solve the request or to make you convenient to download the admit card separately, then it will help a number of users at a time to download the admit card. So when a request is made, rather than creating another process, we are not creating another process because process is heavyweight in nature. It use a lot of resources of your server. So we create threads because threads are lightweight in nature. Yet they do not have to use a lot of resources of your computer system. So when a request is made, rather than creating another process, the server create a new thread to service the request and resume listening for additional requests. Just like I told you that if one request is come, it make a new thread, go download the admit card, and that server is waiting for another request to come and for processing. Let's have a diagram to better understand this concept. Here you can see client is there, it is requesting to download the admit card from the server. Now server has created new thread to service the request. That new thread is created. Now this client can download the admit card with the help of this thread, and this server is eliminated from in between because this thread is taking care of this client right now, and now this is resuming is listening for additional client request. In this manner, with the help of this thread, we can scale. Means scaling means catering a lot of number of users at a time. So this is how multi-server architecture works. Now, what are the benefits of threading? Responsiveness. We are having a very less response time because as soon as the request comes, we create a thread and it processes the request. And then resource sharing, we can better utilize our resources. Economy means if you are using sharing your resources, then you are spending much less cost, and it is scalable in nature, means we can cater a lot of users at a time. So this is the simple context and concept of a thread, how we can scale our programming and how we can cater a lot of users at a time. So let me revise very quickly what we have discussed in thread, then we will go to inter-process communication. What is thread? Thread is a lightweight process, basic unit of CPU utilization, and what it comprises of a thread ID, program counter, register set, and a stack. And what it shares with others, code section, data section, and other resources. And there is a single thread of control and multi-thread control. What is a single thread of control? In single thread of control, you can see that process can perform only one task at a time, but in multi-threaded process, we are having multiple thread control and they can do their job simultaneously. And what is a multi-server architecture? Here, client can send a request to the server. Server create new thread to process that request, and it can resume to listen other users. So this is the concept of thread. As you have seen, that thread are very flexible in nature. They are sharp, right? They are thin. Thin in the sense they are lightweighted, means they are using less resources of your operating system. So we are done with thread. Now let's move to inter-process communication. Now we will discuss inter-process communication, last topic of your first unit. So what is inter-process communication? Means we have studied various processes are there. They can execute whatever they want to have done with the operating system, with the help of operating system. Now, if there is a situation that one process wants to communicate with another process, then what are the benefits of communication and how they can interact with other process for doing some jobs? So this is the concept of inter-process communication. And before starting this concept, I have a question for you. The question is it possible to have concurrency but not parallelism? Just think about it. What is the question? Is it possible to have concurrency but not parallelism? So to answer this question, I have highlighted two words. First one is concurrency and second one is parallelism. So you must have a clear-cut idea about concurrency and parallelism. Only then you can answer this question. Is it possible to have concurrency but not parallelism? So I am giving you 30 seconds. Think about it and let's discuss. If you have clear-cut idea about concurrency and parallelism, then this topic is very easy for you, inter-process communication. In which scenario inter-process communication will come and how we will tackle the problems which will be arises in inter-process communication. Okay, come on. What is concurrency and parallelism? And if you are having some difficulty in defining these terms of concurrency and parallelism, you can give examples, and examples are much better to put your thoughts forward so that we can understand what is parallelism and what is concurrency. You can give some examples. Sir, this is an example of concurrency, and sir, this is an example of parallelism. So can we have some example of concurrency and parallelism? Come on. Looking for your answer. Give some example of concurrency and parallelism. You can give real world example. I'm not looking for any programming example or any virtual world context of this concurrency and parallelism. Just go for real world example. If you have clear cut idea about real world, you can apply your knowledge in your virtual world also. So come on, tell me some example. Okay, I'm asking this question in a different manner. Both the terms are same or different? Firstly, tell me, concurrency and parallelism are same or different? First, answer this question. Concurrency and parallelism are same or different? Come on, type in the chat box, same or different? Okay, Abhishek is saying different. Okay, different. So if they are different, then let's have some example now. Ananya is saying different. Okay, if you are saying they are different, then give some example. Okay, I got one answer from Abhishek Singh. He is saying in parallelism resources will be shared. Okay, the resources will be shared in parallelism. Okay, and what about concurrency? We will not share our resources. Don't go deep in technical, just go for a real world example, then we will better understand, right? Go for some real world example. Okay, sir, in real world, this particular activity happened. We can say that this is an example of concurrency. And in real world, this kind of thing happened, then we can say this is an example of concurrency. Vaibhav has given one example. Concurrency, we deal with multiple tasks. So what do you meaning by dealing with multiple tasks? Are these tasks are executing simultaneously or one by one? That is why I am telling you, don't go in technical thing. go for some real world example. Otherwise, you will not able to defend your answer. Go for some real world example where you have better hold and understanding of real world. In your real life, you have seen somewhere, na? So, okay, this something is going on. Okay. Tell me, you have learned your data structure, na? In your last year, yeah, you have studied data structure, yes or no? I guess you have studied in your second semester, right? You have studied na data structure. Come on, tell me only one student, yes or no? Okay. You have studied data structure. Now, in data structure, you have seen some data structure like stack, queue, right? In graph, so whenever you have out of your house, have you seen, okay, these some things are putting one another. So this is an example of a stack is going on. Okay, there people are standing in a line. This is an example of queue. So these are some real world examples. Okay, I got some answers. Let me read. Abhishek Kumar is saying, like one interviewer's take group interview is concurrency and interviewer take interview one by one is parallelism. Very good. What about Vaibhav Mishra? One task at a time. Not able to get your answer, Vaibhav. What you would like to say here? Priyam is saying, sir, concurrency means using resources at the same time. Example, you are using Zoom app and PPT at the same time. This is an example of concurrency. This may be an example of concurrency. There is one constraint is there. Priyam, your answer is correct, but there is one constraint. I will let you know what constraint you can put it out. Vaibhav is saying, sir, in concurrency, we do one task at a time. In concurrency, we do one task at a time. So how is it concurrent if we are doing one task at a time? How it is? Till now, I got only one good answer from this guy. He is Abhishek Kumar, but he has given his answer privately. Abhishek, if you would like to share your answer with all your classmates so that they can read your answer and can figure it out that what you are trying to say. Okay, good, Abhishek. Thank you. Say, read carefully what Abhishek Kumar Dubey is saying. Like one interviewer take group interview is concurrency, and interviewer take interview one by one is parallelism. So can you figure it out what he is trying to say, and you can come up with some more example? I like his answer, but if this Abhishek has to explain only, then I will understand that this is his own experience by which he is telling this answer, or he has some copy paste from somewhere. So I will talk to him later on, but I like his answer. So other students can figure it out. I'm not saying that he has correctly answered, but I like the way he has answered this question. So you can pick out and find out what is the crux he is trying to say, and you can have some more very good example of concurrency and parallelism. Very good, Abhishek. Good. Come on, I need some more answers. Only then I will move on. I don't care if we cannot complete this inter-process communication today. We can move on next class. Because if we are not learning properly, then there is nothing like we are finishing unit one, we are finishing unit two. I want you to understand the topic and the crux. If you are having the power of imagination, how you can think about these things, like I have given you, you have example of thread. You have to firstly find out where you have seen the thread in your real life. What are the characteristics? You have figured it out by your own. No one is telling that what may be the characteristics of a thread, right? You have figured it out by your own. Now I have just make you understand that how we can use that thread in your operating system context. Similarly, if you have very fair idea about your real world, that where we are using concurrency, where we are using parallelism, and then how we can apply this concept in our virtual world, and why we want to apply that particular concept in our virtual world. There is something in real world that we can have getting from this concurrency kind of thing and this parallelism kind of things, right? So if we are very good with our real world scenario, then we are very good, and we make our computer science knowledge very better in our life. Okay, so let's stop, and you can think. If you are not able to think about this, I have got one answer from Surya Prakash Dwivedi. He is saying, in parallelism, all tasks are working in parallel, start, okay, and end at the same time. Okay, but if some tasks are running concurrently, then the time will not be same, just overlap. Another point of view is given by Surya Prakash. This may be the case. Okay, group discussion is concurrency, and interview is parallelism. Now there is a star, interview is parallelism. If it is a one-to-one interview or one-to-many interview, however, concurrency is the task of running and managing the multiple computations at the same time. Now, don't go in technical and bookish language. I am just asking that what your personal experience in real life. I don't want you to go in technical terms, don't want to go in some bookish language and something else. I don't want that everyone know about, na? Because you can simply search in the Google, what is concurrency, what is parallelism. You have that particular definition and thing also. What I'm looking for, what you can able to deduct from that information that, okay, this is the thing is concurrency you have seen in your real life. That thing I want from you guys, right? So you have to look in that direction, what you want. Like I'm telling you some, giving you information only. Now you have to understand that information, only then it will become your personal knowledge. And now I am looking for that knowledge thing, what you understand by reading this particular content, which is written on a Google or in PDF file or somewhere, what you able to understand. Now, if you understand those things, I'm very happy. If you are able to deduct that information, you are able to analyze that information and can build up your concept, then I will be more than happy that my job is done. This is what I want from my students, that they can think critically and can analyze the information and can deduct that useful information and bring me that particular knowledge. Okay, so I am stopping my today's class. I am giving you this homework. If you want to do, you can do. Otherwise, in next class, I will explain, okay? This is my job only. I have to tell you each and everything, giving you all the concept related to this subject of operating system. But if you do some fight, go on some searching, look, just think about it. You have to go for some real world examples. Okay, in that manner, that can be a parallelism, that can be concurrency. This exercise is very good for your learning, okay? So we will discuss this topic in next class. So tomorrow, maybe finish this, our first unit. If I got some answers from you, otherwise I will not able to finish that unit tomorrow also. If we eat and drink water, then it will be done concurrently, but we could use phone while eating, like parallelism. Okay, that's cool, Surya Prakash. Okay, think about some more examples we will discuss in tomorrow class. Okay, thank you class, bye-bye. Bye-bye.